Hello everyone, we continue with differential equations and we have our second order. We have y this plus f of x and y equals to 0. Then we put p equals to y prime, then this one dp dx is yb, then do 2 is as p prime plus f of x and p equals to 0. Example is the xyb plus y prime plus x equals to 0. Then we divide yb plus y prime divided by x plus 1 equals to 0. Then we put here, this is y prime plus p prime plus p divided by x plus 1 equals to 0. And this is the, we had a method for solution of this type of that it is x plus p plus x 0, and this one is x p 3 plus x equals to 0. Xp equals to minus x2 divided by 2 plus a constant. So p equals to minus x divided by 2 plus a divided by x, which is y prime. Then y equals to minus x2 divided by 4 plus a ln x, a ln x, and so forth. Plus another constant. Yeah, another type of the second degree differential equation is y this plus x of y and y prime equals to 0. By b equals to dp dx equals to dp divided by dy multiplied by dy divided by dx. This is y prime, which is p. Then it is p times dy, and this is p times dy plus f of y and p equals to 0. Example is yb minus y prime 2 plus y prime multiplied by y minus 1 equals to 0. Then it is p Then we have the integral factor by f gives the e multiplied by minus y and the multiplied e minus y dp divided by minus e minus y equals to 1 minus y e minus y, and this is the d dy p e minus y equals to that one. Integral to make it integral from both sides. We have e minus 1 equals to integral e minus 1 minus y e minus y, which is y e minus 1, that's the constant, and the g becomes y plus p e y, and p is d divide dA. Then y equals to thank you. we are going through. And then differential equation, we put this one plus zero, d2 plus 3d plus 2 equals to zero, which is d plus 1, d plus 2 equals to zero, d equals to minus 1, d equals to minus 2. And thank you. heat for cooking up z plus x plus c by d z plus x. Okay, then we have a differential equation g of x, then y is homogeneous to high particular solution, and the homogeneous solution is when p is equal to 0, and we put later we put and solve y p. This is y function, and then we put this y function in that equals to gx and make correspondence, and this we give the tip of the YP. Okay, we are going to use an example. We are going to have a Y4 plus 9YB equals to X minus 2. Then we have R4 plus 9 R2 equals to 0. Then R2 R4 plus 9 R2 plus 9 equals to 0. Then R1 R2 equals 0 and R3 and 4 equals to plus minus 3J. Then the homogeneous solution Y4 equals to C1 plus C2X plus C3 sin 3x plus C4 cosinus 3x. Now we are going to have a y simple C2 plus 3x c3 sin 3x minus 3 c4 this is cooking sin x 3x and yb p equals to minus 9 c3 sin 3x minus 9 c4 4 cosinus 3x, and then y 3 equals to minus 27 c 3 cosinus 3x plus 27 c 4 sinus 3x, and y 4 is minus 80 plus 81 c 3 cosinus sinus 3x, and plus 81 c 4 cosinus 3x. Then in this y 4 plus 9 y 6 is y 4 is 81 c 3 c 6 plus 81 c 4 cosinus 3x. And by this, 9 minus 81 c 3 sin 3 x minus 81 c 4 cosinus 3 x. This is this one here multiplied by 9, and this one is this. Then you can see that we have 81 c 3 minus 81 c 3. Then those two take each other, get why p is a polynomial of grade 4. Then it is a plus bx plus cx2 plus dx3, and why p prime equals to bx plus b plus 2cx plus 3dx2, while b is 2c plus 6dx, y3 is 6d, and y4 is 0. And then then it is 18 c plus 64 d x equals to x minus 2 g h. 7, 64. B equals to 1, then B is 1 divided by 64, and 18, B equals to minus 2, then B equals to minus 1 divided by 9. Then Y is YP plus YH equals to 1 divided by 64X minus 1 divided by 9D and then plus 3x. This is the solution. There is another example also interesting. Then B2 plus 2B minus 1 and plus 1 equals to E power by minus X. Then R2 plus 2B plus 1 equals 0. Then R plus 1 power by 2 is 0. Then R1, 2 is minus 1. Then YH equals to CX plus C2X E powered by minus x, and yp we have is ve minus x, and we put it in that, then 2 times it's ve minus x minus 2 is 2 v minus x plus 1 equals to E minus X. Then E minus X with each other, then V equals to, it is 1, V minus 2, V is minus z plus 1 is 1. Then 1 is z minus x multiplied by 1 plus z1 plus z2 x. Or maybe I can go wrong. Of this, if you have solution also for each part. We have it and solve the solution. Example z2 plus 2z plus 2y equals to 1 plus x plus x sin x. Yh is first r2 plus 2d plus 2r plus 2 equals to 0. Then it is r equals to minus 1 plus minus 1 minus 2, which is minus 1 plus minus j. And then we put it y h equals to e minus h a sin x plus b cosinus x. E use yp equals to yps plus yp2. We have yp2 equals to yb equals to ejx plus ejx plus x ejx. This is here. Thank you. plus J sinus X. 4 cosinus X plus J sinus X plus 5 X cosinus X plus J sinus X. This is to X sin X. 4 cosinus 4 plus 5 x cosinus x 0 and change this one or this one as the complex and solve the solution. Okay. The method is actually theory. And the method is plus y equals to 1 divided by e powered by e powered by x plus 1. And this is e plus 1 multiplied by e plus 2 y equals e. Then b minus 1 or b minus 2, then y whole, y homogen equals to e1 e minus x plus c2 e minus 2 x. And then v equals to t minus x ln tx plus 1 plus e minus x t. But v is, which is t plus 2 1. We must tell this. Then this one becomes e2hy. Then e2xy equals to integral e of x ln e of x plus 1 plus 1 plus 3 dx. E minus 2x and e of x plus 1. This is the solution. This is what? This was the separation or factorization method. In factorization, we take a part as another function and multiply and get and solve the solution, and then we return that one here and use the another continuous solution on that. Habit 1 as 1 and habit 2 as J, and solution C sinus omega k plus alpha equals V C C J alpha, and imaginary of the U is J omega T and equals to U imagine, and D K U of T equals to J omega U and integral U of T. This is the one J omega U. This is the hint or the formula valid for the complex equation. And another interesting thing is Euler's differential equation. That you can see on the right. Another is the Euler differential equation. Have x equals to e power by t. E is positive and x equals to e minus t is negative. Minus. We have a sample x to y b plus 3 is y 3 plus y equals to x squared minus 2 and then x for x greater than 0. Now we put if it's greater than 0, then we put x equals this one in 2t yt plus 3 et yt plus y equals to square et minus 2 ln et et, which is et squared minus 2t. Sorry. Sorry, unexpected. Okay, which is that one, and this one is up to t divided by 2. Okay, now we are going to solve this solution, this equation, and we know that y prime is dy dx, which is dy dk dt dx. X is x divide dk. X is this one and d dk dt dx is 1 divided by x is x. And derive again the yb equals to one divide dk plus x divide dk dx, which is divide dk plus x divide dk dx, which is x2. Now we have we put this in this equation. Particular solution is Euler method and another is a system of differential equation. Okay. eliminate z, and it only marks this bit of z plus 1, and this one with z minus 1, and then add f. And we get z plus 1, z minus z plus b minus 1. Minus 1 y equals to z plus 1 x plus z minus 1 x plus 4. And of the solution, we get z minus z minus 2 y equals to minus 2, and the solution becomes y equals to 1 plus ax plus b, b minus f plus b is 2x. And putting this in that equation or in that equation and solve, then we get z minus x minus 4 minus 2ax plus 800 plus 2b c minus x plus 3c 2x. It only put this one in one of these and solve z, and you get this one. We can also use a matrix form to solve the solution. We can use matrix form and y minus 5 z and this is equal to y minus g z. Then we can change it as y times z equals to 3 minus 5, 1 minus 2 multiplied by y and z. And the solution becomes, lambda equals 2, then dx equals to ab, and lambda 1 is 2 multiplied by e, 2a, 2b. And then we solve this, we get a, b, equals to you want, and for another lambda equals to minus 2, v2 is dv, and a v2 equals to lambda u2, and it is 3c minus 5d, yes, c minus 3d equals to minus 2, a minus 2b, minus 2, c minus 2d, and two solutions, and this is here, this is here, why? Multiplied by C, D, and D. And this is because of this value. Okay, this was on this, but I have another. I have another next, we are going to talk about the Taylor formulas and the Lagrange series, and okay, see you on the next video.